Hello.
Okay, a couple of things I want to say off the top real fast. First of all, okay, I'm gonna have to tune this. I keep knocking. I need to find a different place for the guitar because I keep hitting the guitar on the table. Anyways, what I want to say really quick is it's 4 a.m. I slept 7 hours and I am not I've been taking less anti-anxiety pills, and for the 24-hour cycle that I base the measurement of how much anti-anxiety pills I take, I have been at the my doctor told me to take 2 a day instead of 4, and I've been taking 2 a day. If I make it till 8 a.m., it'll be 2 days in a row that I took 2 a day. And so I will be very anxious, and I think you can hear that in my voice. The other thing I want to say is someone said I should stay completely quiet and just practice, mute all criticism, he said. And I somewhat agree with that, but part of me needs to talk during these videos. I'm kind of talking to myself as well as talking to the camera. I believe it helps me learn. So I just wanted to say that really quick. So you understand, I hope. I feel insecure right now that I have not sufficiently explained the anxiety thing. Basically, it's an addictive. A prescription drug. I have been prescribed it for legitimate reasons, and I'm taking less of it because I don't. It doesn't matter why it's recommended that I take less, and so I can take either 2 or 3 a day is recommended. Ideally 2, and basically I've been at a lower level. Sorry, I'm not practicing yet. Anyways, and I did take my fourth lithium and blah blah blah. I don't think you really need to know about this stuff, but it might affect how I practice, so that's why I say it. Seems a little loud. Oh, yeah, I knew there was something else I wanted to say. It's 4 a.m. right now. So do with that what you will. I'm really feeling I should cave and take the third. I mean, I have 4 hours until the 24-hour cycle is complete. I had 2 cups of coffee when I woke up. I guess there are other ways to relax. I have some water here, and I found myself this weekend chain smoking cigarettes, basically. Because I was so anxious, because I was trying to take less pills. And once again, this was prescribed by a doctor. And I not only did I not ask for it, I kind of specifically asked not to be put on it. So, yeah. Another thing, I haven't had food. I guess you would consider it breakfast. I say that weird, I know. I haven't had food since I woke up, and I probably ate less than usual, less than I usually eat yesterday, and that could be affecting me, but I really felt the urge to pick up the guitar when I woke up. There's this album I listened to on repeat, and I was listening to the album, and I was thinking to myself, I don't want to be listening to this album, I want to be actually playing guitar. And it's a great album, I recommend you listen to it. I assume if you're a good friend of mine or an obsessive stalker, you know what album I'm talking about. It's really sensitive. And a big thank you to the person. Remember, if you look back a number of videos, I'm not saying names from now on, I'm just referring to anyone who helps me as the person or my friend or whatever. And I can thank them in private if they want me to. But thank you to the person who my strings were so out of alignment, tune, I guess you'd call it. My strings were so out of tune that they were not even registering as within the boundaries of what they should be. Basically, I've explained this before. Basically, rock and roll. So basically, I get I don't know. It's basically like it shows, let's say I'm doing E, it'll make a thing that goes from there to there. But if you go so far out of that basic fundamental within the range of E, it starts to think you're playing a different string and a different note. So I needed outside help of someone who actually knows what they're doing. To get me within that range, and then I could perfect it based on the computer. It's a little computer thing. You can see it, I hope. So anyways, E. Okay, just talking about that seems to have put this out of... And it seems to also be based on, I guess if I just play it lightly, it'll give me a bad reading. So this is a practice video, and if you tuned in to hear me go, I was worried before that tuning during a practice video would be boring to viewers, but if you weren't watching this, you would be watching me. Stuff like that, and I assume there's not a huge difference in your mind between that and this. So. See, I'm shaking from nervousness or anxiety, whatever you want to call it. I guess there's a difference between. So that's the. I guess there's a difference between nervousness and anxiety, but I don't want to split hairs. And I think I was told that when you tune, like say the third string, like I just did, that it can change how the sixth string is tuned. Didn't seem to do that in this case, and I can't imagine why that would be the case. I believe they're independent of each other. I'm starting to calm down. So that's good. And I promise myself I will eat when this is done. My hair's. My mom wants me to cut my hair. My head is probably cut off in this video, but I'm sure there are plenty of pictures and videos, because I'm a narcissist, of how long my hair is. But basically the bangs are my real problem. Everything else being equal, I would not cut my hair. I don't know. Yeah, last time I had like really long hair, people on the street started mistaking me for a woman from behind, and I don't think it was like they were insulting me. I think they actually thought I was a woman because of my body type, and I shouldn't be ashamed of that, of course, but it's unsettling, and I'm sure everyone understands, regardless of where they are in life, everyone understands why being thought of as a man and then mistaken for a woman, why that's unsettling. And I could tell you, I could go into that. I don't know. I could discuss issues like those, but that's not what this practice video is for. Not talking about it is probably a statement in itself, but I don't care. This is stupid. It's YouTube. I don't know why I'm going here next. Just have to make sure, yeah. Last week the camera was cutting itself off a few times, so I have to make sure that's still going on. Something I would like to talk about is I have a history of delusions and psychosis and whatever, schizophrenia, bipolar, blah, blah, blah. So my mom says she has, my mom says my mental illness is closer to hers than to my dad's. And she told me that my anxiety, which I've been suffering for a few months, she told me she used to be what's classified probably as delusional. I don't, you know, there's medical definitions and I'm not completely aware of everything, but what I will just call delusional based on my knowledge. She told me she suffered that and it turned into anxiety as she got older, which is, in my opinion, less, it interrupts your life less. So even though I'm anxious, it's actually better. But the weird thing is the anxiety is like, you're kind of anxious about delusions that you don't express, that being said, once you calm down, you realize that there is no need to express the delusion because it was a delusion. So basically you recognize that you're having a delusion as you have a delusion. I don't know if you care about that. This video has been very talky. Should probably just blog about all that stuff. Okay, so I think my problem is my elbow is in the wrong place, so let's get my elbow out of the way. And what am I doing? Obviously I'm attempting G. Look at what I have to do to attempt G. So I saw a picture, like a chart, of how to hold your guitar. And the over one leg position, which I'm doing right now, they said, don't lean over too much. I'm pretty sure I'm leaning over too much, but so what if we bring it up? Okay. And that really hurts my pinky as usual. So we've done, I believe this is E minor. I'm not even gonna check. I believe this is E major. I'm not sure what this is. I'm guessing D, but I don't know if it is D. I know this is C. I actually think this is D. And this would be D minor, if I'm correct. What else is there? It's definitely not F. A, B, C. Oh yeah, I forgot to do A. And in a previous video, I was talking about how this particular fingering that I'm doing right here, I hope you can see enough through. No, if you were here in real life, this would be a lot easier. So this fingering is better than that fingering. in my opinion. If you're on a light full screen and whatever, blow it up. I doubt many of you are here to learn. And I think this is a 7. I'm not sure how smart it is to just guess. I should confirm on that one. Yes, that is a 7. And what was I thinking about before? The A minor, okay. So this one. That's A minor. And I'm feeling kind of spooked right now because I just looked out. There's a window over there and it's just kind of haunting. I guess it's getting close to Halloween, but that's never meant anything as far as I was concerned. So yeah, I've done the 8 main chords that I started out with. And I did A7, and now let's do D7. That was easy. Let's go to the other D's. I should really take a pill. Or eat. Calming down again. So watching this video, you could watch me, my emotions. My emotions go from scared to not scared. I don't know. So this is D major. D minor. D7. I just like grouping those all together. I don't know why I do that. And then so this is a major. A7. A minor, which is that. I think what's creeping me out is the distonality. Is that a word? Let's do that and see if that makes me less frightened. Thank you. feel I'm slightly out of the harmonic, whatever. I'm slightly not harmonic. What does dystonic mean? Dystonia. I'll look that up later if I remember. It doesn't have anything to do with music. I know it's a psychology thing. So that's G7. And my stomach's hungry. I should take some vitamin D since it's 4:33 a.m. How long is this? Okay. So this is E7, and I could group the E's, but I don't really feel like doing that. And how open? Completely open. About all this, I don't know. This is not an affectation, the fact that I'm spooked. How are we going to do this? That goes there. It goes there. There, there. Let's see if we can do this. And one of them is closed, I believe. This is a tricky one. The thing is, I just tuned the guitar, so it should not be out of tune, but a lot of these are not sounding right to me. That sounds right, I guess. What's going on? Okay. Okay. Okay, I don't know what's going on. Technically that should be muted, but for some reason it sounds okay to me, at least with it not muted. But can't fall in love with this chord or you'll turn into a bassist. And nothing wrong with bassists, blah blah blah. Stop apologizing. I hope you can hear me. Spooky. I think what it is I need a cigarette. Okay, let's be professional. Okay, So what's happening is I'm muting it with that finger. So if I go like that and that. Okay. My perception, like the way my eyes and ears and senses interpret the world, is shifting as if I were on some kind of psychedelic drug, I imagine. And I imagine I'm some kind of burnout, which, you know. But it's spooky doing this. So, my ears are changing. I imagine the more I play, not only will my fingering change, but my ears, the way I pick up on certain notes will change. And talking about that, it's all grounded in a very sane reality, but talking about it at 4 a.m. or whatever time it is, spooky. I kind of want to stop playing, but I kind of want to get this over with. It'll be a long time before I can just go to G, especially the way I go to, what is that, E minor. Yeah, I have to always, because this is so easy, because E minor is so easy, I always think of it as E major, but that's not E major. This is E major. Yeah, so let's do this. I spend so little time and put such little effort into this part, but at least I'm doing it. So I don't know if I'm getting... better, per se, at doing this part. I don't know if I'm getting better per se at this, the scales, or whatever you call it, since I spend so little time, but I'm at least keeping it in my memory bank. Put on some Bob Marley or something. Bob Marley seems like the opposite of Halloween. It's not even October and I'm thinking about Halloween. It's just some post I made on Facebook about something that happened on Saturday. Yes. Come on, Ben, push through it, push through it, push through it. I'm seeing how the notes react to something. That actually sounds interesting. Yeah, and I can keep my finger there. That's funny. So, A7. I think you call it step. I step on it here, but I can keep my finger here. And it's still, assuming I wasn't muting the first string with the index finger. But yeah, so I can, if I do this. So. And then I can transition into, okay. Have I actually practiced this? I think the thing is, I feel really sober right now, and the sober feeling is actually very frightening. One of my major flaws is I mute the first string a lot of the time with a lot of different fingerings. That sounds like banjo. Whoa. So, yes. This mirror is creeping me out. One of the things that kind of shot through my conscience, am I saying that right? Anyways, when I was drinking too much, one of the things that really spoke to me is someone in some television show that meant nothing, some line in some TV show, someone said, "Do you even remember the last time you were sober?" Or maybe it wasn't TV, but that. So if I am sober right now, it's not pleasant. No, I had coffee, so what I'm feeling right now is coffee, and I guess coffee's a drug, so I'm not sober because I had coffee. And the coffee will wear off over time. So I should not be overly concerned. What was I doing? These anxious, paranoid thoughts I should not be concerned about. Is this entertaining, me talking about my... I should probably not pose a theoretical question. There was this show in the 80s called Bizarre, and it was on mainstream TV, and on the show they talked about how bad the show was, and it drove me crazy because I was like, yes, it is a bad show, but... Anyway, so I'll say this is a very good show. I've never seen an episode of, who is that guy? Very Big Shoe. I know him only because he was referenced by people of the next generation, and people of the next generation are now people of the, like, as old as you get generation. Okay, I'm gonna stop doing this, because, you know what, yeah, we broke our, I think we broke the record of how long a video is, a practice video is. We're now at almost 42 minutes, and I know a lot of this video is me talking, but I did also play a good amount of guitar, so I don't care what you say, and no one... Mostly no one is saying anything, and if they do say something, they're like, you're getting better, so what, yeah, mute all criticism. I go into this, like, rock and roll thing, and it turns out I'm really bad at it, so I'm sorry. Actually, I love you.